Hello viewers, welcome back, and today we will study the anatomy of teres major muscle. So the teres major is this muscle on the posterior lateral aspect of the scapula, and it is one of those several muscles that connect the scapula to the humerus. Unlike the teres minor, the teres major does not insert onto the capsule of the glenohumeral joint, and so it's not a muscle of the rotator cuff. So the teres major muscle originates from the dorsal aspect of the inferior angle of the scapula. Here on the dorsal aspect of the scapula, the teres major lies just inferior to its fellow muscle, the teres minor, which originates from the lateral border of the scapula, as you can see. From its origin, the teres major muscle travels superolaterally and turns around the anterior aspect of the proximal humerus and inserts through a flat tendon onto the medial lip of the intertubercular groove of the humerus. The tendon of insertion of teres major muscle has a close relation with the insertion of the latissimus dorsi and pectoralis major muscle. Because the latissimus dorsi inserts just lateral to the teres major muscle onto the floor of the intertubercular groove of humerus, while the pectoralis major muscle inserts further lateral to the latissimus dorsi onto the lateral lip of the intertubercular groove of the humerus. This arrangement of these three muscles can be remembered through a mnemonic, the lady between the two majors, where the lady referring to the latissimus dorsi and the two majors referring to the pectoralis major and teres major muscles. The teres major muscle performs a wide range of actions, and it performs these actions mainly by acting through its tendon of insertion onto the proximal humerus. So one of these actions is the shoulder adduction, in which it adducts the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. And this muscle also medially rotates the arm in the same way, acting on the medial lip of the intertubercular groove of humerus. And one another action performed by the teres major muscle is the shoulder extension and hyperextension. And in this action, it acts synergistically with the latissimus dorsi muscle and extends the shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. In terms of the nerve supply, the teres major muscle is supplied by the lower subscapular nerve. The lower subscapular nerve originates from the posterior cord of the brachial plexus, with C5, C6 and C7 cervical nerve roots. Now if we study a little about the arterial supply of the teres major muscle, so two main arteries supply the teres major muscle. These arteries are the circumflex scapular artery and the posterior circumflex humeral artery. The circumflex scapular artery arises from the subscapular artery, and the subscapular artery then arises from the third part of the axillary artery, while the posterior circumflex humeral artery directly originates from the third part of the axillary artery. Now let's give a quick review to all these points which we studied about the teres major muscle. So the teres major muscle originates on the posterior aspect or the dorsal aspect of the inferior angle of the scapula. It inserts onto the medial lip of the intertubercular groove of the humerus. The innervation of this muscle, so this muscle is supplied by the lower subscapular nerve. The arterial supply of the teres major muscle, so two arteries supply the teres major muscle, the circumflex scapular and the posterior circumflex humeral arteries. And the actions performed by this muscle are shoulder adduction, medial rotation of arm, and the extension and hyperextension of shoulder at the glenohumeral joint. So this was about the teres major muscle. Hope you liked this tutorial. Thank you so much.